Hello and a very good morning to all. In this session, we will be learning Standard 9 Geography, Chapter Number 11, Transport and Communication, Part 1. In this first session, we will be learning about the transport. So let's begin by understanding what is transportation. As students, you know that we had learned in our earlier classes, what is transportation? Transportation means moving people and goods from one place to another. Transportation plays an important role in the nation's economy and also has a growth of globalization. Now let us revise what are the modes of transportation. The modes of transport, it describes the way the goods are transported from one place to other place. So there are different modes of transport. Those are roadways, railways, airways, waterways, pipelines and multimodal. We had already learned in our previous classes about the various modes of transport like roadways, railways, waterways, airways. So let's get information about the pipelines. So pipeline transport, it is a long distance transportation of a liquid or a gas through a system of pipes and pipelines. Typically, which take it to market area for consumptions. That is called to be a pipeline transport. And the next one is the multimodal. So, multimodal transport, it is a transportation of goods under a single contract but performed with at least two different modes of transport. So, you can say that multimodal transport is a combination of different modes of transport in order to facilitate or to make the transportation much faster. So, when it comes to the modes of transportation like the multimodal, it means there are more than one kind of vehicle which are necessary to take the goods to their final destination. By the use of various transportation like the truck, train, ship and airplanes. In the picture, you can see there are various modes of transport are used and so this is called as to be the multimodal transport. These transport systems brings about the faster rates of transportation from one place to other. Now, as we have learned that there are various modes of transportation. So, to better understand that which modes of transports would be much convenient for us to use page number 82 of your textbook. Let us see the examples. The very first condition is, suppose you have to reach Bhopal from Nagpur due to some emergency. Which mode of transport would you use then? Understand the condition. It is an emergency that you have to reach Bhopal from Nagpur. Then definitely you would take a flight from Nagpur to Bhopal. What is the reason? Because airways are the fastest means of transportation. And it would be require the minimum amount of time which is ideal in case of any emergency. So we would take airways in this condition. Let us see the second condition. You have to reach Kanyakumari carrying the message of cleanliness and there is no time limit for it. Now here is no condition, there is no time barrier. You can use as much as time to travel or to reach to Kanyakumari. Then we would take a train as a mode of transport. Since there is no time limit, railway would be at economically wiser option to reach Kanyakumari. Now let's see the next condition. In the picture, you can see the Alfonso mango. As you all know that Alfonso mangoes are very famous from Kokan and many of the mangoes are exported to many parts of the world. Now the condition is we have to send the Alfonso mango from Kokan to the Arab countries. Which mode of transport would be used then? It would be the waterways. As we use ship to transport the mangoes because Kokan region is well connected to the Arab countries. Through the sea route and it is the best possible way to transport the Alfonso mangoes. Let us see the next condition. Indrayani varieties of rice has to be exported from Pune to Cape Town of South Africa at low cost. Then which mode of transport would we use? First thing is that we would first use the railway route to transport the rice from Pune to Mumbai. Later, we can use the sea freight to send the rice from Mumbai to Cape Town, because railways and waterways are seems to be right choice for transporting the Indrayani rice from Pune to Cape Town. So, we have to use two modes of transport, that is railways and waterways. Our next condition is condition number 5. At larger scale of vegetable in Nandurbar has taken place. It is not fetching a good price. The Nagpur-Surat National Highway and the Surat-Busawal Railway Line passes through the district. So first we use the Surat-Busawal Railway Line to carry the loaded truck to railway station nearest to Nagpur-Surat National Highway using the Ro-Ro modes. Ro-Ro modes, we are going to learn more about it in the next session. From where the truck would use the highway and carry on the goods and vegetables to the nearest market, where they would get a good price for their produce. Through these examples, we had understood that according to the condition, we can choose our modes of transport. Now, you must have realized that while traveling or transporting goods, we have to consider many things. We have to learn that in some of the conditions which were given in the form of examples, many ways and means of transport available, then we can think about those alternatives, which are the roadways, railways, waterways, airways and pipelines. There are the ways or means by which transportation can be done. Now let us learn the factors that we should keep in mind while selecting the routes and means of transport. So let us begin to learning the factors to be considered for transportation. Let's start with first important factor, and that is physiography. Physiography means a physical condition, like is the region is a mountainous region, or are there more rivers in this area, or is it a snowfall area, or is it a plateau or plain region. This matters more when we consider the first factor, and that is physiography. Because transport facilities developed well in the region with the plains, while the region or the area which has higher relief or weather, it is a mountainous region, then it is difficult to set the transportation system in this area. So one thing has to be remembered or kept in mind, that is the region becomes devoid of transportation route if the physiography of the region is not suitable for the construction of the transportation route. Next important factor is the route and means. Depending upon the region, we have to choose the means of transportation. Next thing is route. So when when many routes are passing through that region, then we have to find, or it becomes economically, that which is short route to carry transportation to that particular destination. So that way it will be time consuming and also fuel consuming. So this is also one of the important factor, routes and means. The next factor is market. See, in the urban area like Pune, Mumbai, Nagpur, markets are more developed. Goods are also available in plenty, and also they are sold in plenty. But it is not necessary that all the goods which are sold in this market in urban areas, they are manufactured in that places, that is Pune, Mumbai or Nagpur. But many times they even have to be imported from the other state or from the other district. So in this area, the transportation are more developed because these are connected with many places or many state or district. So market is also one of the important factor to be considered for transportation. The next factor is the climatic condition. Due to the change in the climate, like a storm, snowfall or heavy rainfall, or due to the flood condition, there would cause a delay as well as a permanent or temporary closure of the routes. This may lead to the obstruction for the transportation purpose. It may cause delay. Next factor is time. So as we have already learned in the condition which we had done in the beginning of the lesson, that if it is a matter of saving the time, then we can use the airways. The next factor is duration. So if it is a short duration journey of transportation, then roadways would be the better option for transportation of the products. And if it is a long journey of transportation, such time railway, airways would be the best option. The next factor is the products. The size and the weight of the products plays an important role in deciding which modes of transportation to be used. Land and air transport is good for light and small transportation, like small shipments of the goods, while railway and sea routes are good for heavy transportation. So deciding which means would be used is dependent on which kind of product is being transported. Next three factors are cost, duration and distance. If we consider the above mentioned factor, then our time and money is saved during the journey or transport, and our traveling becomes more comfortable. Transportation is done without any damage of goods. Okay, next is the goods or products we buy from the market. It is not decided only on the product cost, but along with that, the production cost and manufacturing cost, various expenses are added to it, like packing of the material, storage facilities, worker wages, and also transportation are added. Transportation charges is a major factor, you can say, when the selling price of goods is decided, all these charges are added to it. So if the transportation cost is low, then the selling price of the goods will be low. But if the transportation charges are high, then definitely the selling price of goods or product will be very high. Next is the transport of freight. Should be done rapidly or safely. Freight means the goods which are transported in a bulk, in a large amount by a truck, train or a ship, it is called as freight. If it is a perishable commodity or a very high delicate or a very fragile commodity, at such a time, it becomes very important to do the transportation very safely and quickly. Transportation is a basic infrastructure. Infrastructure, it means the basic facilities is available in a town, in a village, in a city or in the nation, is called to be as the infrastructure. Infrastructure facilities are developed well. As various progress and development are made in the transport sector, as I told you that India has one of the largest transport sector which is more developed, but even more and more development is still going on to enhance the dynamicity of freight and passengers. Due to the infrastructure, transport infrastructures are developed. As a result, industries and market will develop, and so the economic growth of the nation will also be encouraged. Per capita income, PCI, and gross domestic product, GDP, increase too. Let us see what is GDP. GDP is the value of all services produced and consumed within national economic growth. GDP can be calculated in three ways, using expenditure, production or incomes. Next is per capita income, PCI, or average income, increases the average income earned per person in a given area in a specified year. It is calculated by dividing the area's total income by its total population. So now you all must have understood that if the transport sector is well of a nation, then the economic growth will definitely well in a nation, and as a result, the per capita income, the gross domestic product of the nation, increases too. Now let us understand the transport route. To better understand the relation between the physiography and transport system, let us see the example of Satara district. Here we have map of Satara district. Now when you observe the map, you can see the distribution of transport route in the form of dense network in many part of the Satara district. At some places, transport route system is dense, while some places it is a sparse network. Here you can see. As the western part of Satara district, it has a higher elevation, or you can see it is a mountainous region. It has an undulating topography, and as a result, there is a sparse network of transport in this region. In this region, there is an extensive Shivsagar reservoir of the Koyna Dam. See, if you look at the physical map, here you can find that the Sahyadri mountain ranges, the Bamnoli range, or here you can find the Koyna Nagar. There are the places where you can find transport route is lacking in this region. The western region of Satara district have the obstruction from the Sahyadri ranges, from the Bamnoli ranges, all so many rivers passes through it. And these cause the obstruction that hinder the development of transport route. So now students, you must have realized that the physiography, that is the hills and valleys, the rivers of a region affects its transport route. So there is a correlation between the transport route and the physiography of the region.
So students, I hope you all have understood till here. This is the end of part 1. Thank you.